International Journal of Health Policy and Management. Quality and speed are our culture and the keys to our success. Welcome to the audio summary section of the International Journal of Health Policy and Management.
Hello from Tehran to everyone watching. I'm Sara Kazempour-Ardebili, and I'm going to talk a little bit about an editorial that I wrote in partnership with Dr. Amirhossein Pakyan for the International Journal of Health Policy and Management in April 2016. The article is titled Diabetes Dictating Policy, an editorial commemorating World Health Day 2016. As you may well know, World Health Day is a global health awareness day held every year on April 7th by the World Health Organization with the aim of raising awareness to current global health challenges. It has been held annually since 1950 and focuses on a specific public health issue each year. This year's World Health Day theme was Halt the Rise, Beat Diabetes. On the same day, WHO released its first Global Diabetes Report, a document that outlines the effects of diabetes on individuals, communities, health systems, and governments, and also proposes a framework for surveillance, prevention, and effective management of diabetes, and emphasizes that diabetes can be delayed and even prevented through efficient planning and policy making. Our editorial is an account of the policies that have been set in action to combat the increasing prevalence of diabetes and have led to this year's Global Diabetes Report. We start with the 2011 Political Declaration on the Prevention and Control of Non-communicable Diseases, which is a resolution adopted by the United Nations General Assembly at the high-level meeting of the Assembly specifically held for this purpose in September 2011. The Political Declaration is a document which heads of states and governments and their representatives recognize the rising prevalence, morbidity, and mortality of NCDs worldwide and address the need for population-wide multi-sectorial policies and interventions to tackle this problem. The 2011 declaration led to the 2013 Global Monitoring Framework developed by the World Health Assembly, which outlined the 9 now well-known voluntary targets to be reached by 2025 in the fight against NCDs. This was accompanied by the WHO Global Action Plan, which provides guidance on reaching the framework targets. NCDs are also recognized as a threat to sustainable development and therefore addressed in the 2015 United Nations Development Summit. In fact, prevention and control of NCDs is among the objectives set to be achieved by 2030 for sustainable development. Finally, we take a look at how Iran, an upper middle income nation in the region with the fastest growth rate in prevalence of diabetes, is translating and implementing these global policies. I hope you take the time to read the article, and obviously, we would welcome your thoughts and views on this issue. Thank you and goodbye.